Good evening. Thanks so much for joining us. The UH football game is just getting underway at Aloha Stadium, and the team will be playing with heavy hearts. UH running back Willis Wilson died early this morning at Sandy Beach. Kirk Matthews joins us with our top story. Kirk.
Marissa, a sad scene at Sandy Beach this morning as friends of Willis Wilson waited on the shore for word of what happened to him. It was a solemn gathering at Sandy's this morning, just hours after Willis Wilson disappeared in the surf before sunrise. Fire department and Coast Guard rescue crews arrived as soon as possible.
A wave came and pulled them into the water. When what was explained to me, they turned around and they didn't see their friend. So that's when they called. You know, they didn't notice him. You know, they turned around and he was gone.
And according to veteran surfers, that's just how fast it can happen, especially in the dark.
It can be very dangerous. I've done it when it's full moon. You know, it's possible, and it's when it's pitch black. We have overcast. It's pitch black out here in the morning, and I respect the ocean.
Wilson and friends were reportedly partying at Sandy's early this morning when a rogue wave knocked them down. His friends managed to make it safely to shore, but when they looked, Wilson was missing.
All the fire and rescue were here with probably about 15 officers, and it was more of a body recovery when I got here.
Lifeguards say Sandy's has the highest rate of broken backs and necks in the nation. No one knows yet what led to Wilson's death.
I just feel horrible for his family, you know. But yeah, it's definitely one of the, you know, I've watched 13 people in my lifetime go paralyzed, paraplegic from injuries at Sandy's, you know. It's a really, really dangerous beach.
This morning, that beach proved just how dangerous it can be.
Veteran body surfers, the seasoned guys don't even really attempt to go out there at all. You know, it's just kind of sloppy and a lot of undertow. But it can be dangerous.
The 20-year-old Wilson was a backup running back for the Rainbow football team. Kirk Matthews, KHON 2 News.